There are very many good people in this world, but there are only a few who can be regarded as truly great. They keep themselves above the trivialities of life and are motivated by an irrepressible sense of mission in life. Founder Secretary of Ramakrishna Mission Ashram Narendrapur and former Secretary of Ramakrishna Mission Institute of Culture Kolkata, Swami Lokeshwaranandaji Maharaj was one such great monk, a monk without frontiers. He looked upon the whole humanity as one huge family and felt concerned about its welfare and progress. Swami Lokeshwaranandaji Maharaj was born on 19th April 1909 in Kiragachi in the district of Khulna, East Bengal, now Bangladesh, the place where Yavan Haridas, a disciple of Sri Chaitanya, was born. Kiragachi was Lokeshwaranandaji's mother's village. Kiragachi was famous for its Rama temple with the images of Rama, Sita, Lakshman and Mahavir. The people who lived at Kiragachi and the neighboring villages considered Rama to be their guardian. They felt they all were under his protection. Before Kanai left home forever to become a monk, he went to Kiragachi and sought Rama's permission. Kanai did his primary education up to class 4 from Hakimpur School on the other side of the river Sonai. Swami Lokeshwaranandaji's mother was Shikhor Bashini Devi and his father was Basant Kumar Bandopadhyay. Although he was given the name Shivapado at birth, he was always known by his nickname Kanai. Kanai was very close to his mother and most influenced by her. Even when he was a child, she inspired him to become a monk. His father's home was in Baripada at the village Magura in Satkhira. Rani Rashmani's son-in-law Mathur lived at Sonabede, a village close to Baripada, and the villages around it were under his jurisdiction. Once, Sri Ramakrishna and Hriday accompanied Mathur Babu to his home village of Tala. Kanai had his secondary education at the B-Day institution and he passed his matriculation exam at the Lalmanirhat School in Rangpur. The headmaster of his school, Srish Chandra Sanyal, was his main inspiration. Swami Lokeshwaranandaji said, the headmaster always talked about Sri Ramakrishna, Ma and Swamiji. That would take me to another world. I'd listen to him for hours, completely unaware of the time. Neither of us felt tired, neither the speaker nor the listener. Sometimes he would lend me some books to read. He also advised me to spend more time in meditation. Back home, I tried to meditate as long as I could. My heart was full of bliss. I didn't care much for studies. The other teachers would say, "We expect you to get a scholarship in the exam. You have to be a judge or a magistrate." But the headmaster protested, "Don't pay any attention to them. I want you to be a monk." One day, his wife scolded him, "Why are you asking someone else's son to become a monk? How will his parents feel? Why don't you advise your own son to be a monk?" But the headmaster replied, "I'd be very happy if my son really becomes a monk. I deem it a privilege for him to as well as for our family." One day, the headmaster said, Mahapurush Maharaj is staying at Belur Math now. Please go there soon and ask him for his blessings. In Lokesharanandaji's own words, I accepted Mahapurush Maharaj as my guru from that very day. I decided to go to Belur Math by any means and take refuge at his feet. Swami Lokeshwaranandaji said,
it was 3:30 in the afternoon and the temples were just opening. I entered, there was nobody there. Only one monk was there and I said, where is the shrine? He said, go this way. You have to climb up the steps. It is on the first floor. You know, the temple had not then come into being. There was the old shrine. It was on the first floor of an old building. As I was climbing, Swami Sivananda, who lived just opposite the shrine, he was on the first floor. He opened the window of his room. He saw me. Even as I look back, I feel he was waiting for me, as if he was waiting to welcome me. He knew I was coming. There's no reason why he himself should open the window. He had a tendency, might have asked somebody, open the window. But he did open it, and opened it, and saw me, and began to laugh. Hello, where are you from? Who are you? Very happy. I didn't know what to say. At once, two attendants came running to me. They took me to him. And he repeated the same question. And when I said that I had just finished my school course, he wouldn't believe it. And he wouldn't even believe it that I had come all the way on a bicycle. Look, this boy, barely 16, he has finished his school course. Or maybe I looked much shorter than I should have, given my age. But some or other, he thought it incredible that I should have finished my school course at that age, and that I had come all the way on a bicycle from that far off place, Khedirpur, as it is known. And he was very kind. And that is how it started. And all the senior monks began to love me. In fact, as I look back, I feel they spoiled me in a way, you know. They made me think very highly of myself. All of them were very kind to me. And one day, Swami Atma Bolhananda, my teacher's maternal uncle, had by then come down to Belur Math, and a few others took me to Mahapurush Maharaj. Of course, I used to go to him whenever I visited Belur Math, and I visited it every Sunday. And they said, Maharaj, he's a very nice boy, but he hasn't had any initiation yet. Will you please initiate him? And I began to weep, you know. Why I began to weep, I don't know, I began to weep. And he was very pleased, said, yes, Baba. Baba means father, but you sometimes address your own child as Baba. Yes, Baba, certainly, right away I will give you my initiation. Well, I don't care for formalities. So he started giving me the mantra. And the monks who had come to introduce me to him ran away. And he initiated me then and there. You see, that is how it happened, my initiation.
Rama Rama Rama, Sri Rama.
Lokeshwaranandaji Maharaj took charge of the Pathuriyaghata Ashram in May-June 1946. Maharaj himself was then living from hand to mouth. He had practically nothing at his disposal. Still, he wanted to keep the students without charge. Although the ashrama continued to grow and thrive, the surrounding area was not favorable for an educational institution. As a result, the residents of the students' home were having great difficulty with their studies and spiritual practices. A new place called Ukhila Paikpada near Rajpur was selected. The government acquired the land and handed it over to the Ramakrishna Mission on 30th March 1956. The name Narendrapur was given to the place by Swami Madhavanandaji Maharaj, the General Secretary of the Ramakrishna Mott and Mission. At that time, Swami Shankaranandaji Maharaj was the President of the Ramakrishna Mott and Mission. He consecrated the foundation of Brahmananda Bhavan on the auspicious day of Makar Sankranti on 14th January 1957. The college came into being 2 years after the school. Then came the Blind Boys Academy. The history of Pathuriyaghata's evolution to Narendrapur will remain incomplete unless we mention Rambagan. In Swami Lokeshwaranandaji's own words, Rambagan turned into an ill-reputed slum whose inhabitants were called domes. But one could hardly see anywhere else people with such artistic talent and intelligence as these inhabitants of Rambagan. They were poor and uneducated, and it is difficult to imagine how they lived in such unhygienic surroundings. A night school was started for adult education. Later, we opened a school for the children also. These days, they are being trained in various kinds of handiwork, and their per capita income has also increased. The old huts have been torn down and a new multi-storied housing complex has been built for them. The slum dwellers themselves took part in the construction work. In 1993-94, Swami Lokeshwaranandaji was appointed the convener of the centenary celebrations of Swami Vivekananda's address at the World's Parliament of Religions in Chicago.
Now that the Parliament of Religions has practically concluded, I, as convener, thank you all on behalf of the Central Committee appointed by the Ramakrishna Mott and the Ramakrishna Mission.